finally,
I get to talk about something that is not comic related.
Let's go.
The intention for my channel wasn't to make video essays on comic book movies, but look how that turned out. So today, I want to talk about something different. Today, I want to talk about something personal. Today, I want to talk about... Picture your favorite movie as a child. Picture why it was your favorite movie when you were younger. Picture how impactful that movie was to you. Picture how much that movie changed you as a kid, and maybe even how it impacted you when you grew older. And if you asked me to picture that movie, my answer wouldn't be Star Wars, my answer wouldn't be Spy Kids, my answer wouldn't be Disney classics. No, for me, my answer would be Earth to Echo. So chances are you probably haven't heard of this movie, and I don't blame you. I put a post on Twitter saying what are people's childhood favourite movies, and none of them said Earth to Echo. And I genuinely don't think that many people have seen the hit film sci-fi action kids movie that is Earth to Echo. And I know you're probably thinking, is it any good? Well, that's a question that I ask myself all the time. Is it any good? You see, I have very mixed feelings over this movie. There are a lot of aspects of the movie that are good. There are a lot of aspects of the movie that are great. But to me, my biggest problem with Earth to Echo was Echo. So the movie starts with a group of friends who are trying to make films and videos, but then come across something supernatural that causes the government to be involved and chase after the kids. I don't know if I just explained Super 8 or Earth to Echo, because this movie copies from other movies. I guess what the movie was trying to do was be like the ET for this generation, but did it succeed? Well, to an extent. It has all the heart that you would expect from a kids movie. It has all the mystery that you would expect from a kids movie. It has all the action that you would expect from a kids movie. But something that the movie doesn't have is the bond with the center point of the movie, Echo. But before we talk about Echo, let's talk about the good in the movie. One of the stand-ups of the movie that actually keeps you entertained and actually gives you a reason not to turn off the movie is the kids. The three main kids, Alex, Munch, and Tuck, who have been pretty much nobody for their whole lives. Alex is a foster kid who moves house very frequently, has nobody except his friends. And Munch is a loser who absolutely has nobody except his friends. People just assume he's weird and that's it, they move on, but deep down he's actually a really nice person. Tuck is a YouTuber, he likes making videos, he likes making films and things like that. He tries to act like the big man in front of his friends, but really he's just lonely. His parents ignore him and his brother is horrible, so I guess he just wants attention. Okay, that's it, you've established the characters, but how do you make it feel like they are all very good friends, and how do you make the film feel very raw and untouched? Well, you make it a found footage film. The found footage genre works for some films, but definitely not others. And luckily for this movie, the found footage style of filmmaking actually works. In my opinion, it enhances the movie. It makes the movie feel very, like I said, raw and unique. And it feels like the movie is told from the kids' point of view. So what pushes the story and the weight of the movie is that it is Alex's last day of spending time with his friends because he's moving house. So they decide to follow the strange map that they found on their phones. But take away all the sci-fi stuff from this movie and you get a very touching story about friendship and how moving impacts it and what it means to move away and, well, grow up. That's what I wish this movie had more of. I wish they refrained from making this movie an ET for this generation. I wish the movie was its own thing. So they nailed the stuff that they did with the kids. They nailed the stuff that they did with the mystery. They nailed the heart. They nailed the style of the movie. So why does this movie still not work? The movie doesn't work because Echo doesn't work. Echo is meant to play a very huge part in making you care about the movie. If Echo doesn't work, the movie doesn't work. And the thing is, they build up the kids' relationships. But when they find Echo, the kids are like,
oh, we're bonding with Echo. Echo is our new friend, even though we met him like 10 minutes ago.
Echo is the thing that the kids are trying to save. Echo is supposed to raise the stakes for the movie. But because you don't care about Echo, you don't care about the kids and what they are trying to do. I guess if they took time to build up Echo and make him bond with the kids and actually have a connection, the payoff of this movie would have been so much better. So when they finally save Echo and look at all the times that they spent together, you think for a bit and realize that they literally have only been with Echo for a day, and they don't really have that many good times, so this moment doesn't make you care about the characters. So Echo leaves and he returns home safely.
Yay! Happy story, right?
Wait, we forgot something. It's moving day. Oh yeah, Alex is moving. Alex is about to leave. And this ending here, when they talk about how much friendship means to each other, and they talk about how they will always be friends, no matter where they are in the universe, makes me really mad. Because this is genuinely a very grounded and emotional ending, and it is an ending that would have impacted you if the rest of the movie built up to the moment. That's like me showing you the ending of Endgame or Honey Boy without giving any context. Yeah, the ending is very sad, but you don't know the characters that well, so you can't connect with them. So if they actually took time to develop the characters and to make it feel like there was actual weight, this would have been one of my favorite kids movies ever.